There's been a remarkable show of strength from two families today after an unimaginable tragedy killed four young children at Oatland in Sydney's northwest. One mother has offered forgiveness to the man accused of being drunk behind the wheel, while the parents of Samuel Davidson, the man facing charges over the crash, today express their deepest remorse for the victims.
They could have so easily tried to hide from the pain and the shame. But today, Kay and Alan Davidson faced the tragedy.
We're absolutely devastated for the loss of those children. Mm.
Their plan of living out a quiet life on the Central Coast is now unlikely, while their son, Samuel Davidson, remains behind bars.
We're no stranger to grief. We lost it. A daughter 10 years ago, and now effectively we've lost our son.
The retired police detective and his wife shattered. Their son allegedly drunk behind the wheel of this car when police say it mounted a curb in Oatlands, killing siblings 13-year-old Anthony, 12-year-old Angelina, 9-year-old Sienna, and their cousin, 11-year-old Veronique, four beautiful faces now at the forefront of the Davidsons' minds.
Those poor families have lost their children. No words can help them. Yeah. And I'm so sorry to them.
Today, foil balloons fluttered above flowers, teddy bears and candles placed at the scene.
Danny and myself were blessed to have six kids. We had Anthony, Angelina, Liana, Sienna, Alex and Michael. We love our kids so much. I'd like to thank everyone for their love and their support. Me and my husband are overwhelmed with the love and the support that they've shown us.
Support which continues to swell, a testament to the love and strength of this community. And while today the families continue to rally around each other, tonight Samuel Davidson faces a second lonely night in custody. Isolated for his own safety, Kay and Alan say their son worked as a truck driver. Now they say he's remorseful.
He is so sorry. He can't believe that what's happened.
He has a good heart, and I'm sure he's just as devastated as we are and understands the consequences for his actions, which won't be, we won't be seeing him for many years, I'm sure.
Three families now coming to grips with the fact that their lives will never be the same.
I think in my heart I forgive him, but I want the court to be fair.
Early Walsh, Nine News.
And Nine News reporter Elizabeth Bryan is at Oatlands this evening, where there's a growing tribute for the young children killed in the crash. Lizzie, there are now pleas for speed bumps to be installed in the area.
Yeah, that's right, Pete. Locals here say that several Oatlands roads are notorious for speeders. They want those speed bumps to be put in place to force them to slow down and take care on these roads. It comes as experts are saying that they're calling for a total ban on drinking before driving.
We accept zero blood alcohol concentrations in all states in Australia for our learners, for our P-platers and for our commercial drivers. Tragedies like this should give us pause to consider and reflect, are there things that we can still do better to prevent this frequent tragedy of an alcohol-affected driving crash?
And just barely 24 hours after this crash, a woman was arrested on the far north coast, allegedly six times the legal limit and travelling with a three-year-old in the car. As we see more and more mourners turn up here tonight with flowers, safety officials are saying we need to do better to stop yet another family going through such unimaginable pain.